Oh. Good evening.
Good evening.
Happy Christmas.
Happy.
The first word is from the prophet Isaiah, and that word tells us what he will do, what he will give to all of mankind. It's found in the 52nd chapter of Isaiah, and if you turn to page 1144 or 1146 in the Bibles in your pews, you will see that word. We'll be looking at verses 7 to 10 of that 52nd chapter. I'll give you a moment because this is a very important prophecy, a very important promise for the entire human race. But I want you to let me know that you're there, so if you're there, please say amen.
Amen.
And here it is. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who bring good tidings, who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your watchmen lift up their voices. Together they shout for joy. When the Lord returns to Zion, they will see it with their own eyes. Burst into songs of joy together, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord will lay bare his holy arm in the presence of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth will see the salvation of our God. This is the word of the Lord. We don't know who exactly wrote this second lesson, but we know he was serious about the gospel of Jesus Christ and about making sure it was absolutely clear. If you turn to page 1860 in the Bibles in your pews, 1860 or 1862, you will find the book that this person wrote to the first Jewish Christians, the book of Hebrews. And we're going to look at the first 12 verses and talk about just how important this child is. Hebrews 1, starting at verse 1 to verse 12. If you're there, please say amen.
Amen.
And here it comes. In the past, God spoke to our forefathers through the prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, and through whom he made the universe. The Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact representation of his being, sustaining all things by his powerful word. After he had provided purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty in heaven. So he became as much superior to the angels as the name he has inherited is superior to theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, today I have become your father"? Or again, "I will be his father, and he will be my son"? And again, when God brings his firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all God's angels worship him." In speaking of the angels, he says, "He makes his angels winds, his servants flames of fire." But about the Son, he says, "Your throne, O God, will last forever and ever, and righteousness will be the scepter of your kingdom. You have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore God, your God, has set you above your companions by anointing you with the oil of joy." He also says, "In the beginning, O Lord, you laid the foundations of the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain. They will all wear out like a garment. You will roll them up like a robe. Like a garment they will be changed. But you remain the same, and your years will never end." This is the word of the Lord.
Shine. golden days. Happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. The years we all will be together, if the fates allow, hang a shining star above the highest.
Thank you.
John, the first chapter. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that light was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not overcome it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not that light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet, to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become the children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or of a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John testifies concerning him. He cries out saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me has surpassed me, because he was before me.' From the fullness of his grace, we have all received one blessing after another. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but God, the only begotten Son, who is at the Father's side, he has made him known." This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. in the tree. How much fun it's gonna be together. Yeah. This Christmas, my shiny place is bright. We're caroling through the night. And this Christmas can be very special Christmas for me.
This most holy night, and you can feel the joy of the Spirit of the Lord in this place. Let's thank the Lord again for all the wonderful singing, the reading of His Word, and being blessed in His house tonight on this most holy night. Join me in prayer, if you would, saints. Most gracious and merciful Heavenly Father, here we are, pausing our lives again, allowing you to immerse us in your Word and immerse us by the Spirit to show us the way. You've given us the gift of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the way, the truth, and the life. And how thankful we are tonight that we can celebrate his coming to us as our Emmanuel, God with us. We thank you, Lord, that we have your holy, divine, and inerrant word to direct our every footsteps in this journey of life. We praise and thank you, Lord God, that the Spirit opens our hearts and our minds to be receptive to the teachings coming from your holy, divine, and inerrant word. And so we ask you, Lord God, tonight that as we continue to be like sponges here, Lord God, soaking it all up, that we will respond in gratitude and in thanksgiving and go and share this good news that has been shared with us. Because we know, Heavenly Father, that you desire for every man, woman, and child on the face of this earth to be able to sing praises to you with the anticipation of being able to see you face to face one day. And so, Father, tonight, as we soak this all up in our spirits and in our minds, may we be prepared to generously give it away as we leave your sanctuary tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Saints, we heard our deacon tonight share the good news with us from the prophet Isaiah, from the writer to the Hebrews, and of course to John. And to that, I want you to just say amen.
Amen.
I want us to, if we could, just get into another mode of just singing happy birthday to our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. You know, when it's your birthday, you want someone to sing for you, amen?
Amen?
And you like when people sing happy birthday to you because it gives you a sense of joy and praise and thanksgiving because you realize what a blessing it is to even have life. Well, tonight as we join our hearts and our voices together to sing happy birthday to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, there is no greater birthday song than to sing for our Lord, amen? So please stand with me if you would as we join our voices and hearts together tonight and sing happy birthday to our Lord and Savior and King Jesus Christ.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jesus. Happy
happy and joyous Christmas celebration with family members and friends. I pray that you'll use this time to really just enjoy family and friends. Enjoy this time to give praise and thanks to God for his goodness, his grace, his mercy, and his love, all found in the gift of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. I'd always encourage the congregation to relish and cherish the moments in this journey of life. And this is the time in our lives we should be doing that. And we should be rejoicing that God has blessed us throughout this past year and has blessed us really to see just this day. And when we wake up tomorrow morning, not only will we be filled with joy and praise and thanksgiving because it is the day of the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, but we will know that God has blessed us once again. Amen? He has blessed us once again with a new day. In our text for tonight, we hear the good news coming to us from the Old Testament, from the epistles and from John. We see where John is laying out what true love is all about for us as a people of God. We see very clearly this love means that we have to grasp it and hold on to it because it comes to us in the form of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. As the New Testament church in 2017 and almost into 2018, if it is the Lord, amen, these texts tonight really remind us that God has had a plan for us as his sons and his daughters from since the time he created Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. But we know the story how sin crept in. Amen. Anyone not know the story? We know how sin crept into the garden and how sin was able to draw them out of a fellowship with our Heavenly Father. Tonight, our text secondly confirmed for us that real love came to us through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ coming into this world and then bridged this new relationship with our Heavenly Father that we broke in the Garden of Eden. And third, our text tonight remind us to open our hearts and our minds to the future. To the future plans that God has for us. Yesterday, it's over. Amen? Today, we are living in this. It's almost done. Only thing we have is hope that God would allow us to see a new day, if it is his will. How will we treat tomorrow if God desires us to see it? Think about that. How will we treat tomorrow if God desires us to see it? I pray that we will take the word of God as we normally do and we will immerse ourselves in his word. so that all the worries and fears and doubts of this life in which we face each and every day, that they will be taken away because we will be affirmed that God has a plan, a divine plan for each and every one of us. I pray that we allow the Holy Spirit to teach us a little bit more about the plans that God has for us. We know that the Word tells us that God desires to bless us and to prosper us and to guide us all the way to the gates of heaven. I pray that we allow that plan to be unfolded in our lives each and every day as we're praising and thanking God for another day. We are blessed people. Tell your neighbor, I am blessed. Tell them again, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
We don't want to take the blessings that God has given to us for granted, especially the blessed gift of Jesus Christ. We have to take the blessed gift of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ and all the blessings God has given to us in this life, and we have to treasure them. And I'm going to use another word. We have to covet them. Because we know that God has given us His Son and He's given us the blessings that we have so we may use them to glorify His holy name and to tell others about Him coming to us. We heard about the love story from John tonight. We call that agape love, saints. The love between us and our Heavenly Father and our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, agape love. That's the kind of love we want to remember tonight as we think about love coming down to us in the form of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. We want to remember that kind of love because it's that love that we share with our family over this weekend and in this Christmas season. Is that love we share with our friends and with our spouses? Is that love that we share with our parents and grandchildren and great-grandchildren? Is that love we share because it's all built on Jesus Christ coming to us as our Lord and Savior and King, showing Himself to be the greatest love of all in our lives, showing us the depths of the love that He has for the Father, by willing to be the reconciler, drawing us back, saints, to the Father, showing us each and every day as we're in the Word and listening to the Spirit in our hearts that all is well because of the love relationship we have with Him and the Father. Think about it. Without this love relationship we have with our Lord and Savior and King Jesus Christ, where would we be? The love that comes to us is always overflowing. It always meets 100% of our needs. The love that we have is always expanding time and place for us that we might be living examples and witnesses of His love. The love that we have coming to us through Jesus Christ, it never ever fades, and it always guides us in this journey of life. And it will guide us each and every day until we see our Father face to face. Hey, your neighbor, that's good news.
That's good news.
That's good news. You see, saints, when it comes to understanding love, sometimes we want to take that love and make it a general kind of thing. But it is, of course, the agape love that we have amongst ourselves that the Father shows to us. But it's also that phileo love, that brotherly, sisterly love that we should be sharing amongst each other. And of course, it's that eros, that romantic, passionate, intimate love that those who have that type of love are sharing in a relationship. But all that love comes from one person, found in our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, saints. God loves us, and He found us in the depth of our sin, and He sent that love to us that we would not be lost forever, and that love is everlasting. That's why we are here tonight. Now, how are we going to respond? I trust that we'll respond the way you've heard the choir respond. I trust we'll respond the way you've heard our deacon read the scriptures tonight. I trust we'll respond in such a way that is praise and thanks and glory and honor to our God. I trust and respond with feelings that I don't deserve this love, but thanks be to God that He shared this love with me. I trust and respond and said, God did not have to allow the Son. He was not obligated to. But how grateful I am that He allowed His Son to come for me. Jesus Christ is our eternal love letter from the Father. It's a wonderful letter, amen? He is our eternal love letter from the Father. And that letter is filled with everything that you need, saints. If you're going through a difficult time in life, go read the love letter. Amen. If you're having a wonderful time, you want to praise God for His blessing, go back and read the love letter. Amen. If you're having some questions and some doubts about issues and problems and concerns in this life, unquote, life shows up on your doorstep, go back and read the love letter. And give praise and thanks and honor to our God that He is guiding us every day because of His love for us, found in His Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. You might even want to shout hallelujah. Amen. And let the Lord know that you're going to rejoice every day that He has sent Jesus, an example of righteousness and holiness for us to follow in our lives. There's a song that we enjoy singing in church every once in a while. And that song is entitled, Father, I Adore You. Jesus, I Adore You. Spirit, I Adore You. Join me in singing if you would.
Father, I adore You, and I lay my life before You. How I love You, Spirit, I adore You, and I lay my life before You. How I love You, Spirit, I adore You, and I lay my life before You. How I love You.
Jesus is our love for the saints. And the love we have for our triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is nothing more than a response of the love that has come to us. In the joy of this season, we don't want this season to get away from us and thinking, oh, it's just Christmas. No, it is the holiest of holiest seasons. And we want to honor our God as we tell the good news of Jesus coming to us, our Emmanuel. Amen? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, how joyful we are tonight that we are here to experience Your love letter in song and in word and in fellowship with one another. We thank You that You came down to us, Jesus, and we thank You that You've been guiding us by the power of the Holy Spirit each and every day of our lives. Thank You for filling in the gap for us when we were separated from our Father. Thank You for showing us that the reconciliation plan has been completed in Your coming, in Your walking amongst us, and ultimately in Your victory over sin, death, and the grave on the cross. Continue to flow through us, Lord Jesus, Your love, so that those that we see around us may experience You the way that we do, with joy and praise and thanksgiving in our hearts. For we want to see You, Father. We want to join all the saints who have gone before us. We want those around us in our family, those in our classrooms, those in our workplace, our neighbors, and even the stranger along the way, and those in the marketplace to see You one day. And we know that will only happen if we put our faith and tell them to put their faith in the love that came from heaven. Jesus Christ, our Lord, Savior, and King. In his name we pray. Amen and amen. We join the angels. We join the heavenly host tonight on this most holy night as we sing this song as a people of God. Because we realize that without the gift from heaven, we would be in serious trouble. Thank God that he came to us as our Emmanuel, God with us, and that all the concerns in his life have been taken care of. Even when we go through difficulty, we know that because of Jesus, everything's going to be all right. Amen. We join the church around the world tonight who also sing Silent Night with us. Thanksgiving to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I ask us to rise at this time as we sing together, Silent Night.